Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne. We are going to be continuing with the Agora Models Bismarck, the legendary battleship, Pack 6. Now before I get onto the ship, and this is where we got up to after Pack 5, I've got to let you know of everything that's going on at Agora Models at the moment, because I have been on vacation and I'm aware that they've dropped quite a few serious releases that are coming in September and October. So the first one we've got coming in September is the Jaguar E-Type, then we've got the New York Fire Department Ladder 9 Fire Truck, and then finally we've got the Rootmaster. Now all of those are linked over at the Agora Models website, agoramodels.com, and you'll be able to get that all the way from Pack 1, including a plethora of other items that they do, like the Terminator and the Zero Fighter. And I think we're going to have some of those videos later on in the week for the Zero Fighter and the Leopard Tank. But without further ado, Pack 6 of the Bismarck. So we're going to be starting this build with Pack 57, and we're going to be doing the 15 centimeter gun. You'll see we've got some photo etching there, and we've got some things on sprues as well. So we are going to need our sprue cutters. We're also going to need our detailed glasses, because this is going to get a little bit fiddly. So I'm just bringing over the superstructure deck here, because we're going to be working on this side just at the top here, because we've got some details just to be putting into the deck here. And we also want the sprue looking like this, and they are different. We've got four on the top which are all the same, two different ones here, two different ones here. It's these ones here that we want, which are the rangefinders. And this is what the rangefinder looks like, so I'm just going to put that in a little bit of glue, and they're going to go just into the hole that we can see right here. Now I've got this so that the actual scopes are pointing towards the bow of the ship. So that's the first one. And there's the second one. So they should look like that. The next details we're going to put in are the searchlight directors, and they look just like this. They're going to go in all the other holes that we can see just on top there. Now, once again, they are all facing forward to the bow. So I'm just putting a little bit of glue into all of these holes. And when they're all in, they should look just like that. We can put this to one side, and I'm going to bring over the photo etch parts here and take these all off the plate, because we're going to be working on these next. And the first photo etch detail we need looks like this, and we're just going to be folding the sides of this up along the score line there. I'm going to use my duckbill pliers for that, just at a 90 degree angle. So that's one. Now I'll do the other side. And that's two. In a similar fashion, I'm going to be taking the deck and railings here and burning the railings up at 90 degrees. One and two. Also going to be bending the back tabs of this up at 90 as well. So now that should look like that. Bring over the superstructure deck, because the first thing we're going to do is we're going to be putting aerials just onto the forward section of the tower here. Now these actually go underneath, but they're going underneath this section here. There are two little holes, which I don't know if you can see these on the close-up camera. I'll try and point them out to you. The two holes just underneath this section right here, this is where they're going to go into. But out of the whole build, when I built this previously, the hardest thing to do is to keep these in. They keep wanting to come out. So make sure you put a lot of glue in those holes. But I'll put one of them in, and this is the first one that's got some little kind of circles, as you can see there on it. And we'll get this in. That's looking good. And that's the first one on, just like that. We're going to repeat that for the other side. I'll show you on the top camera, that's what they look like when they're in. Now this underside support platform is going to go onto the underside of the foretop gallery, which is this section here, just underneath here. There is sort of like a ribbed bit of decking that this can slot over. It's got slots in there. We're going to slot that over. It's probably best to look at the pictures for this, but that's in place just there, if you can see that underneath. We've then got this platform which is going in the holes in between this section here. Now, I've already put glue in those holes, so it's just a case of putting this in. So when that's in, it should look like that. I found it easier to put the platform in first and then the support in afterwards, rather than do it the other way around. We've this then just got another two of the antenna outriggers, which look just like that. And once again, they're just going to go on the underside of this section into the two holes that we can see just here. Probably again, best to look at the picture, because I do know it's not the easiest thing to film. And when they're both in, just looking at the top, they should look like that. So we can put this to one side again, because we're going to be starting to assemble the 15 centimeter gun. So we've got the base looking like this. We've got the guns that are just going to go through here, making sure that they rest on the pivot there. Putting in the other side here, which has got the other side of the pivot. That's going to keep that in place, just like that. And that's going to be held in with a 2x5mm screw. Now they're the ones that I've got two in a pack of, and they just go through the hole just at the bottom here. Tighten that up. There we go. That should be able to move quite freely now like that. I've removed the superstructure deck now from this deck because it's going to go into here, just into the hole that we've got there. Just sits in like that so it can go round. Now we're going to actually work on the mechanics for this. So turn it upside down, and we've got this little joiner to put in there. If you have a look on the gun, you have got a sort of extrusion on this side with a notch for it to go in there. So it can only go in one way, like that. And then that's going to be held in with some screws, and they are 1.7x6mm screws, and that's the one that you've got four in a pack of on this stage. Make that nice and tight, and then we'll just put the other two in. Now we want to rotate this gun, as you can see, now that's all in. We want to rotate this till these arms are centered between this point just here, because we're going to be putting the switch in. Now this is what the switch looks like. We've just got to put a sticker on it, and the sticker we've got here is B15, which is on, and then we're going to be putting the switch in here with the white side facing down. So it looks like this. So that when this spins, as you can see, the gun is going to be able to activate the switch there, one way and the other. Now this is going to be held in with one of the flange screws we've got, which is a PWB screw. And that's just going to go into the side here. And that will keep that switch into place. Now this is really important. We've got two kinds of circuit boards here. We've got this one, where the plugs are either side of each other. This is only for testing motors. We've got this one where they're opposite each other. This one's only for testing LEDs. Don't mix them up, otherwise you're gonna blow your lights. So what we're gonna be doing is finally, we're gonna be able to test the LED lights. So now I'm gonna test all the leads from number 5 all the way to number 9. So this is B5. Get this in here. Turn it on. And that should be the green navigation light, which, as you can see, has come on there. So that's B5. Let's do B6. Plug that in. And I'm guessing that, yes it is, as you can see, is the red navigation light there. Looking like that. Turn that one off. B7 is the bridge light. And that looks like that. B8 is the Admiral's bridge, which looks like that. Turn that one off. And the last one, B9, is the searchlight. And I think this is where we started from. As you can see, the searchlight's on. So all the electrics are working, and that's all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 58 looks like that is the motor for the 15 centimeter turret that we just worked out. And all we have to do first off, take the lead here, and we're going to be putting the little sticky number on. The other end of this is going to go into the control board on the motor here. Then we're going to have the drive cog here. That's just going to go on the end of the motor. And then we're going to be putting this just into the deck where that 15 centimeter gun was. So this is going to sit in here. But what we want to do is make sure it's this way around with the actual lead part facing upwards. So when we put this in, it's going to engage. We want this bit in the center there with the cog below it there. So it should be able to turn, as you can see. We're going to hold that whole thing in place with this cover. That's going to go over the top to keep that all in. That's going to be secured with the screws that come in this pack. And with that completed, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 59, we've got another hole section here, just with some screws. And we have also got a little photo etch details. So the first thing I'll do is just take these off the actual plate. Now bringing over the superstructure deck, the first detail is just going to go into the three holes that we can just see on top there. So I'll put some glue in here. 1, 2, and 3. And I can just put this in freehand, making sure it's sitting straight. Right, now if we look just above the Admiral's deck here, you can see we have got this little walkway. I don't know if you can see that on any camera, probably on the top camera is going to be best. This little walkway here, the next part is just going to go onto that section there. That looks just like this. The arms of this are going to be facing out like that, so we just need to glue this into place. Now the tab at the back actually goes onto the top of the platform. But this time, I am going to use my tweezers to help me out with this. And there we go, that's gone in absolutely perfect first time. So we can put the superstructure deck to one side because we're going to be attaching another hole piece now. So you'll see with the hole pieces, I'll keep everything in here from the catapults to the control boards to spare leads to planes, just so I don't lose anything. Because me, I'm telling you, I will lose everything. Now this is going on the port side here, quite simply just underneath. It raises up to the next section like this, and it's screwed in with 2x4mm screws. So I've got them here. We'll get 3 of those in. Just like that, all secure, and that's all there is to do in that stage. Now the next set of instructions in stage 60, I'm actually doing back to front, because while I've got the actual hole unit here, there's no point in keep swapping it around, because this one once again does come with some photo etch, but we'll put that on in the latter half of it. What I'm going to do is just put the next hole piece on, which goes under here, and then once again 2x4mm screws just to keep that all into place. And there we go, that's on. Now I can keep that to one side. Now I'm just going to take all of this photo etch details off the plate, because we're going to be bending this around. And the first piece looks like this. Get my duckbill pliers, because we're just going to bend up the railings here, just like that. And we've got another railing part here just to glue onto the other side of this. Now I've zoomed in quite a way this time, just so I can get some glue just into these holes and show you what I'm actually doing. Now there is a little indent on the end. We want to make sure they're the same on both pieces, so the indent on the end here needs to face forwards. But there you go, that's what that should look like. We need to bring over the superstructure deck again, and this time this piece is just going to be fitting under this section just here. So before we put this on, you've got two little tabs at the end. They're just going to need to be bent upwards, so I'll use my duckbill pliers for that. So I'm just going to put some glue underneath where this is going. One here. And when that's in, that platform should look like that. Now we've done that platform, I've got a very, very tiny section to put in there. That looks just like this. Going to tap that in a bit of glue, because that's going to go into the slot that we can see into the platform we've just put in. And it's going to sit in just like that, kind of at an angle, because then what we're going to do is get part B, which looks like that, and that's just going to go over the top of that part we've just put in. So when that's in, it's going to look just like that. Quite a fiddly little thing, but that is all there is to do in that stage. Put that to one side again, because we are going to start now working on the funnel deck looking like that. So we're going to start this pretty much like we did last time with a 15 centimeter gun. Now we should be dab hands at this now. So all we've got to do is take the gun barrels again, put them in, making sure that it's over the pivot point there. This is exactly like we did last time, closing it off by putting the other side in, making sure the pivot points are also on there. It should fit smooth and you should still be able to move these up and down. And then that's going to be held in by these screws. Don't worry too much about the size. It's the ones with two in there. But we're only using one. You get plenty of spares in this build. And then once we've done that, once again, we're going to be bringing over the deck. Put this in there, just like the last one. Turn it over. Again, matching off the shape here with the notch that we've got there. And then this is going to be secured in with the 1.7 by 6 mil screws. And that takes three of these. Once they're in, all we've got to do is take the next lead, the next switch lead here. And we do have to put a sticker on that, and that's sticker B3. You want to make sure all of your leads have got labels on, because when we actually connect these to the control board later on, it'll be a living nightmare if you haven't. And just like last time, we want to make sure that this is facing down, so that the white part here is facing down in here, just like this. And then that's going to be held in with one of the PWB screws, which are the flange screws. And I've got one here, so I'll just get that screwed all the way in. And there we go, that's the next switch in place. So once again, when this turns, it's going to be able to operate that switch. We can put that to one side, because we've got some photo etch parts again to deal with, exactly like we had last time. So we're going to just create the other section on the superstructure deck. So it should be a dab hand at this now. So once again, we're just going to bend this railing up like that, apply some glue just to the holes in here. 1, 2, 3. And then putting the other side of the railing on, making sure that the railing is tilted in exactly the same way as the one that we've just bent up. That'll just go in like that. We need to bend up the end tabs on here. So I'm going to use my tweezers, I think, this time. Two. They're all bent up. Bring over the superstructure deck again. And where we put this one in last time, we're just going to do exactly the same thing on the other side. So I'll glue this in and show you what that looks like. So there we go, there's the one in on the other side. And once again, just like we did here, we're going to follow exactly the same technique, and we're going to be putting that in the other side. So when they're both in, they should look like that. We can put this to one side, because we're going to be attaching the two sections of the funnel deck together. These quite simply are just going to go into the lugs and the holes on each side. We do want to just drop some glue just into here. So we'll just put a little bit around where each one is going to lock into place. And then quite simply just piece them all together. Now with plastic parts like this, another way you can do it is use some of the extra thin cement and just let the capillary action carry it down the seams of the center join here. But with that section done, that's all there is to do in that stage. Now, stage 63 can seem daunting. We're going to be putting two spotlights into the spotlight deck. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make one, and then once you've seen how to do that, you just repeat that for the other one. But before we even attempt that, we're just going to be putting the motor we've just created into this side here, exactly like we'll be working on last time, mirroring exactly like you see there. So we're going to be putting the cog on the end of the motor. That's just going to slip into this section here, like so. And then we're going to hold all of that into place with the cover here, just over the top. Oops, other way around. And then that's held in with two of the black screws that come in this pack. And that one's two. So the motor is fixed. That means we now have two working 15 centimeter guns when we power them up. So I can put that to one side, and we're gonna start building the funnel deck. So we need the top here and the grill. They're the first two things that we're gonna need, and they're gonna go just into each other like that. We are gonna need to glue these into place. So I'm just gonna put a ring of glue just around this section here. Now rather than put it all around, I just dot it in random places. That'll be enough to hold it. No problems at all, like that. And then that goes on like that. Then we need to put the base in. Now the base is gonna go into the bottom of that section there, like that. And they do recommend gluing that in. I've actually just pushed mine in rather than glue it because it does hold itself. But if you wanna glue it, you can glue it. The instructions do tell you to glue it. And then this whole thing is gonna go onto the funnel deck that we built last time, with the raised section going towards the boot part of the funnel deck, just like that. So we need to glue this into place. And now we put that to one side because we're gonna create the spotlights. Now each spotlight is coming on its own sprue. So what I'm gonna do, just break off all the parts from the sprue. Now we have actually created a spotlight before, so if you don't remember how to do it, hopefully this little catch up we'll help you out with that. We're gonna hold it this way around and just put a clear lens in first. This is what the clear lens looks like. It goes in with the flat part of the little top part facing down. And bring over one of the LEDs. I'm just gonna take the wire off of it and put a label on. This label is B10. Once we've got the lamp, we're gonna be taking this collar part here and we're just gonna be threading that this way around and just let it hang down the end of the cable. We put the lamp inside this lamp holder here, making sure it's facing upright and that the wire is coming out the trough there. Then we glue around the outside of this lamp holder here that we created first. I've already put glue on this, push that into place, and there we go. We have got one spotlight almost done. We've just got to put the supports on for that. The first support looks just like this. This doesn't get glued. This just clips into the holes that we can see at the side. So now that sits in like that. Then we want to channel this wire down through the structure here. So the wire is actually just going to go through this. You can see a little track for that to go in like that. And then we're going to close it off on the other side by putting some glue in these holes, one and two, and piece that together with the mount on the other side here. So we can still move that through there, but we have got support in there. What we're gonna do then is we're gonna be gluing the top of that support we've just put in. I'll put some glue around here with the support we put on the back of the lantern. You'll see there's a hole in the back there. So it's gonna go in like that. And now that's all one unit. And then all we have to do is bring up the base here, or the hat section, and glue that to the bottom of the spotlight. So I'll put some glue here. Whoops. Just put that around this section here. Put them together. And there we go. That is one spotlight completed. We're going to repeat that for the second one. And there we go. We've got two spotlights. So quite simply, we're just going to be taking the spotlight deck looking like this, and we're going to feed these through the tops here so that they come out from the bottom. So that's one. And this one in here is two. Then we're going to be putting this onto this section here. But we want to make sure that the wires trowel into these troughed areas here, because we're going to need to pull them quite taut afterwards. So one will go in here like this. And the other one, get that through. Now they do want us to put a little bit of super glue just into this deck here, which I've already done. So that's why that's held in. And then all we're going to be doing is we're going to be gluing the spotlights down to where they go here by pulling the cables as well to keep that nice and tight. And it's up to you what way you have the spotlights facing. Personally for me, I like them slightly off at an angle rather than pointing directly ahead. So I'm going to be putting one sort of like in that direction there, I think. So that looks like that. And being a master of symmetry, I'm going to repeat that on the other one. Just pointing slightly in the other way. Like that. Now we're going to be putting this on the funnel deck. So we've got some holes just here and here. We're going to make sure that we put these in where they go. So the first one will be going into the right side here. Like that. One in this side. And when we're happy, we're just going to pull those wires through. And I'm going to be applying some glue just to this middle section hole here. Now that should be enough to hold the full deck when we actually slot this in. Again, keep pulling the wires because you don't want them being pinched. That looks perfect. And there we go. So we can put that to one side because we've got a couple more photo etch parts here, which I'm just going to break off. Bring over the superstructure deck. And these are just going to go on either side of the top section here. So once again, a little bit of glue in the holes. That's the first one in. And do the second. When that's done, should look like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Nice easy one for stage 64. We just got a bit of deck and we've got some babettes to put in. And just like last time, all you're going to do is line up where the tabs are. You're going to have to be a bit forceful with this one to get these in. But they will go. Like that. That's the first one in. And the second one. Sometimes your screwdriver can be your friend with this. Just to get them in. Do this last one. Just by pushing the tabs in. And there we go. They're in. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now this build absolutely delights in searchlights. The more searchlights you put up, the more it's going to make the ship pop. So rather than repeat everything we've just done, I'm going to create these searchlights now, show you what they look like, and we'll continue from there. And there you go, with the wonders of editing, that's another two spotlights done. So we can put them to one side, bring over the funnel deck again, and it's this back section that I'm interested in at the moment. And that's because we've got this base looking like that, which is just going to go into this section here like that. So once again, just apply some glue, just the holes here. And a little bit around the side where this is going to clip in. And push this into place. Like that. And then just like last time, we're going to be assembling the spotlights onto this section here. So they're going to sit on kind of like that. So we just need to glue these into place exactly where we want them. There we go. Excellent. Two spotlights on another deck. Now these ones are going to be going into the holes that we can see on the funnel deck just here and here. So once again, I'm going to get these lined up, feed the cables through. That's one. And two. And just like last time, I'll apply some glue just into the channel in the middle there and just a little bit either side of that hole. So that when that's on, and I've got this in, it's going to sit on just like that. Now you have got some ledges either side that I can put a little bit of glue on just to ensure that stays into place there. So one this side, and I'll do the same just on the other side here. Lift it up, put some glue under the ledge, put it down, and then that's going to stay in place. But there we go, we've got four spotlights now on that funnel deck. Then all we need to do now is put the shelters for the spotlights. We've got a port one and we've got a starboard one here. So we just make sure that the curve here follows the curve of the front of the funnel. So this one's going to go in here and it's actually attached onto the base. So we just need to put some glue just onto the bigger holes in the base. I said holes then, but it's only actually one hole that's going to keep that in. But I'll keep that perfect. Do the same on the other side. And that one's in as well. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now I'm going to be doing issues 66 and 68 together, because while I've got the whole section round, I may as well put these two bits in together. So that's why the chaptering is a little bit out here and it's not in order. But it just makes more sense that while I've got the ship with the hull over here, that we do all of these parts together. So I'm just going to get these two whole section pieces out here and I'll go bring the hull over. And we're a dab hand at this now. We can see how this goes. We're going to have the starboard one going on that side, the port one going on that side, and then we have these little tabs which look like this, which are just going to go between them. So one here and one on the other side here, like that. And all of this is going to be held in with 2x4mm screws. There you go. That's both of those in. Now I can put the hole to one side because that's those stages complete. Which means we're now working on making the third 15cm gun. And this will be the last stage of this whole pack. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this section again. Once again, we're dab hand at this. Put the gun barrel in. Just like that. Close it off with the other side, making sure that the pivot section is over the top. Hold that all in place with one of the screws where there's two in a pack. Just like that. But this time, something slightly different. We're going to be actually attaching some platforms to either side of this gun. So we're going to have one this side here, this way round, and one on the other side. So I'll get some glue. There we go, there's the second one in. So we've got two platforms on there now, looking like that. Bring over the deck again, because this one's now going to be going on the port side over here, like that. And exactly like last time, we're going to turn it upside down. We're going to be attaching the little plastic cog, making sure we line up that little section there. Here's the freeze screws going in. That's going to hold this into place. This has been quite an in-depth pack. And as a matter of fact, just so you know, I've actually split the filming into two sections. And it's taken a good on 3 or 4 hours, I'd say, to actually do the filming for this. God knows how long the edit's taken for this. But then once that's in, I want to make sure that I position it so that the guns are facing out. So when we put the switch in, they're not going to clash on the deck behind, but they look just like that. All we've got left to do then is put the switch in. Before we do that, we just need to put the little sticker on, which says B17. Just around there like that. We're a dab hand at this. The switch goes this way round into this section here. And then we've got one of the PWB screws to just put that in here. That'll keep that nice and secure while I tighten it up. And there you go. With that fitted, that's all there is to do in that stage, and that's all there is to do in that pack. So what I think we'll do is we'll actually build this up to what we've actually created so far. So this deck's now going to fit in there, which we are able to do. It's probably best on the side camera. Then we'll have the superstructure deck with all of these wires. Just post all of them through there so I can fit the superstructure deck on. And then this will give you an idea of how much we've actually done. Just like that. Wow. And then the funnel deck will go over to this section here. Let's just put all of those wires through. Pretty much like that. But that's just a basic idea of how everything's going. But that looks pretty impressive, doesn't it? And that's going to keep it all tidy. We do have another deck, which was obviously sent, which is over here. But that's going to be done next time, which we'll keep safe. But there you go, the first Bismarck build in the new workshop. And I'm sure you agree, looking good, looking absolutely good. If you want to get this for yourself, put the link down the bottom here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one. If you're unsure if they deliver to your territory, just drop them a note and they'll advise you accordingly. Anyway, I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.